Mayor, I've got a quick question for you. By APD's own admission, they did let their guard down after the Sunday night march. What's been the conversation between you and Chief Geyer about that, and what's the plan going forward to keep that from happening again?
Sure, you know, for us, our plan is always to be as prepared as possible. And in any situation where we have things like protests, but, you know, potentially violence and so forth, the plan changes every day. So each day we learn, we talk each day, and we update sort of what we're doing. But, you know, we want to keep the protesters safe, and we want to keep our city safe as well. And so our teams, the standard procedure is if there is ever violence, they will engage and just as best they can de-escalate and break up what's happening. But otherwise, they will be on standby and let people express their right to do free speech. So for us, you know, it does involve lots of resources and challenges and things like this. And inevitably, there's going to be, there's, you know, hopefully just minor mistakes and small challenges. And I think in this world, no one ever wants to see broken windows at the chemo. But in the grand scheme of things, I think our team and the peaceful protesters saved the chemo and no one was seriously injured. So these are, you know, minor tweaks that are definitely expected during a time of uncertainty. Mm-hmm. And so far, I'm grateful Albuquerque has only had those incidents.
As Chief Administrative Officer, you work with the chief closely. Have you had conversations on this regard as well?
We have, and I actually got a chance to spend an evening in the control center where all the different agencies get together and make sure that, as the mayor said, those tactical plans are rapidly evolving and the lessons learned each day of the protests have been rapidly incorporated into the way we're doing things now. Mm-hmm. I think you can see the evidence of that in the fact that we've had 2 days of peaceful protests that didn't have that part two where people took advantage of the situation to cause property damage.
Gotcha. Picking up on that, Mayor, I appreciate what Sarita just said there, because we did have a peaceful protest in the rain just a night ago as we taped this on Wednesday early afternoon. But I'm curious, part of the route change to incorporate a bit of Lomas and then cutting down south towards Civic Plaza, is that part of the plan now to reroute some of the marching if it is to happen to be away from businesses?
Well, I think for us, I mean, you know, in this kind of situation, we don't always know where folks are going. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. And we always actually, if we do know the organizers at any level, you know, historically with all our marches, whether it's around gun violence or women's rights, we usually do try and coordinate the route to keep protesters safe and also to block traffic. So if we're aware of a route, we try and make it safe for the protesters and the businesses. And it actually is kind of in the best interest of everyone to be aware of the route. When we're not aware of the route, obviously it makes it just a lot harder to keep everyone safe.
Mm-hmm. And the goal is usually when we're using barriers to stop vehicular traffic so that the protesters are safe, as opposed to trying to control where people are walking or marching.
Yeah. In fact, we allow people to go through those barriers on foot.
How closely do you work as an administration with the organizers? Do you get heads up on everything, on some things? How does that work?
Well, I think it's a real mix. You know, again, we try and reach out as best that we can. And I think some of the groups, especially ones that have been more established or advocates that even I know from, you know, when I was out there protesting after James Boyd, you know, we try and have that communication, but we certainly, there's a generational issue. Some of us are kind of aging out. and so, you know, we certainly aren't in touch with everyone, but there are certainly some that we still are.
There's now credible reporting out there that APD officers were seen meeting with some guys that are part of a so-called militia group out there.
Take care of each other and they think, take care of the people in Albuquerque. And some of these guys are just dummies. They see crime of opportunity.
It's roiling the community in quite a ways, because the pictures just are not great, seeing men with long guns and, you know, camo out in our streets during a peaceful march. What was your reaction when you saw that, Mayor?
It was completely inappropriate. And okay. I'm frankly grateful that it was caught on video and shared with us, because we probably would never have known about it if it hadn't been for the folks in the community who trusted us enough to share that information with us. Those officers are under investigation. Their actions were completely taken on their own and not directed by APD. And APD renounces any vigilantism or use of you know, people are, have their rights, but open carrying at protests has a tendency to escalate rather than de-escalate the situation. And de-escalation is, of course, always our goal.
Hopefully this is an example where we know these challenges are going to occur, and we want to know about them right away, and then we want to take action. But I also know, and there's enough inherent chaos and things like this, that like these challenges are going to come up. We hope and believe that they'll be small, and that we can take care of them right away the next day. And so, you know, I'm sure there are going to be other incidents, but it's our job to do everything we can to prevent them, but also to stop them as soon as we hear about them. And that's what we'll keep doing.
Gotcha. Let me talk about the damage that happened in the part, the court of central downtown. Is there a notion to perhaps help out some of those business owners that lost some very expensive windows downtown and that may or may not be covered by insurance? Might the city be able to help out in that regard in some ways?
Absolutely. So the morning of, we sent our crews out to clean graffiti. It was all gone by the time I got down there at about 11. We assisted with boarding up windows, and then business owners who have been affected by these incidents are to call 311, and we'd be happy to share any other resources that we can to help them get through this.
Gotcha. Mayor, there's been a call from the Albuquerque Journal that perhaps the National Guard should be put on standby of some sort and institute a curfew. At the time of the printing, you were opposed to that. If there was another incident out there that was unexpected, would you in fact make that call?
Well, I think we have to think through what's happening nationally and what's happening in our city. And those two things are obviously very related, but they're also very different. And so what that means is that we've got to do what's right for Albuquerque. We have to carve our own path. And we saw during Corona, for example, we did our own thing and we demonstrated that we were a healthier city than most major cities. Right now, I decided that we should not have a curfew. And I think that is in sharp contrast to cities that implemented a curfew right away and are now more violent and more dangerous. And the message is being diluted by the violence. So that's why we did not decide to do a curfew. So we really want to avoid that. We don't want to do that. Now, if there's a situation, of course, where we actually lose control, right? Where APD, not just for 10 minutes or an hour, but when we feel that we are out of control, we will act without hesitation to do everything we can to restore public safety. And that includes a curfew in National Guard. But that really is a last resort. And I want to remind folks that it doesn't necessarily even mean it'll help. You want to, at that point, have every tool at the city's disposal. But what we've seen in other cities, it has actually made things worse. And from a message perspective, it is completely distracting from the point of the peaceful protests.
Mayor Tim Keller, Chief Administrative Officer Sarita Nair, thank you guys for spending some time with us. It's been a busy week for sure, certainly in your office. We appreciate it.
Thanks, thank you. Chief. Appreciate you covering this.
Good
Take care.
You. Be safe.
Absolutely.